So, just to recap, just beat the two giants and the fortress on the western approach. This is part 8 of the series of Dragon Age Inquisition.
The Inquisition was here on his butt.
Still breathing. He's resilient, I'll give him that.
He could still be of use if we interrogate him.
Have some of the troops bring him in. I'll deal with him back at Skyhold.
mage. But at least it is done.
Important for anyone to come here.
Thank you.
Might be something here. Better take a closer look.
I'll admit it. I'm curious. You know, I bet I...
recall, Durin's theory of High Dragon behavior is absurd, but... Oh, yes? Did you need something?
One tail feather and one batch of intestines, as requested.
My friend, you are invaluable. I will certainly note your assistance in my monograph on the High Dragon. I will attempt to lure her out as soon as my background research is complete. Mistakes could be deadly. The ancient Tevinters wrote volumes on the study of dragons. I believe they had a laboratory in this desert. If only their work had not been lost. Truly, the blights set the field of draconology back centuries. Deplorable.
I've spotted several dragon signs around the approach.
Most excellent, my friend. I don't suppose you noted the wound pattern? No matter, I'll look into that later. Andrast is mercy. From what I can tell, the dragon has been moving east and will be scouring the wastes next. Naturally, the dragon's hunting ground is full of miscreants. White Claw raiders. They've covered the area in traps for Maker only knows reasons. Quite a mess.
We'll have to speak some other time.
Before you is Servus of the Minrathus Circle of Magi. You met him and his Venatori in the Western Approach. He admits to working for Corypheus, raising monsters and using magic for conquest. He also used his connections to smuggle magical artifacts out of the Approach, without his master's consent.
You stole from Corypheus. I don't know whether that's stupidly brave or bravely stupid.
I was hired by a third party. I've no loyalty to him. Might you find that useful, Your Worship?
I'm sorry, are you attempting to bargain with us?
Bargain? I plead. I throw myself on your mercy. I also have friends in Tevinter who owe me large debts. Leave what happened in the Approach behind us, Inquisitor, and I can put them all at your disposal.
Someone who can smuggle magical artifacts to Tevinter and back shouldn't be wasted on court diplomacy. Bring those artifacts back to the Inquisition. Procure something really useful, and we might loosen the shackles.
Your Worship knows value when he sees it. I won't disappoint.
Okay, we'll go in the war room, do some bullshit. Get another perk.
Did you see the message I sent?
Yes, thank you. At your service. Inquisitor.
To work?
Is mightier, my answer.
Just to update, I'm probably going to be updating like every day one of my episodes to YouTube, which will be Trihelix Gaming. So if you missed the live stream, don't worry, I'll upload it to you. I upload them to YouTube. Some of them are long because I don't cut. I just put them live on YouTube, so. So heads up.
The spiderwebs help stop the bleeding, and they prevent wounds from getting infected. Gather as many as you can.
I can keep staring at this, but I won't get any closer.
Something I can help you with?
Yes. Possibly. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
They're gone. What difference does it make where they are?
I left the Order, but I can never abandon them. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it. What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
I was hoping you'd be happy about it.
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was falsely accused.
Well, it turns out the guardsmen...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
Varric's the one you should be thanking.
I am but a humble servant to my loyal readers.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it.
I understand if resources cannot be spared to help search for the missing Seekers, Inquisitor. Still... It could involve a threat we are unaware
Cassandra,
of.
Cassandra, what
there
are you
may
doing?
Be a use in looking.
Do you have any advice for me?
Tell that demon. What does it call itself? Cole. Tell it to leave. He may not mean harm, but that does not mean he will not harm us. Spirits are not creatures to take at face value. Be cautious with him, Inquisitor.
Do you have any advice for me?
It's good that you recruited Enchanter Vivian into the Inquisition. She is ambitious, but has always shown sense in her dealings with the Chantry. My advice would be to watch her, but heed her when she speaks. That one wastes no words.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
You know, I should probably talk to Sarah, considering I haven't this entire time.
Well, about time you came around to talk, innit? Sign me up, then not so much as a welcome. Little busy, I hope, making sure this new place can keep out a pissing archdemon. And the thing controlling it, that we're hunting. Drosdale, what do I step in?
Let me know what she says. I could use some clarification myself.
It's swearing, not praying. She doesn't answer. Not like she's supposed to. I know what happened to you, or what everyone here thinks happened. It seems... I don't know what it seems.
I can't help if you don't explain what's wrong exactly.
It's got to be nonsense, doesn't it? What kind of screwed if it isn't? I mean, that Corifi thing. A magister, right? Story is, he cracked the Golden City. But that's a hazy dream. If not, seat of the Maker, real thing. A seat needs a butt, so the Maker,
real thing.
Fairy stories about the start and end of the world, real things.
Yeah.
It's too far, isn't it? I just want to plug the Skyhole rubbish so I can go play.
You joined to help the little people caught up in this. But do you believe or not?
In Andraste? Of course.
But you doubt what you're seeing and hearing.
It can't be true. Even fanatics don't want to be this right. Look, I have arrows. I can make this Corypholis believe in those.
Corypholis? That sounds like a fucking transmitted disease.
Keep calling it nonsense. That perspective will keep the Inquisition grounded.
Oh, I can do that. Sure could use a few more people shouting no. We fight, the bad things go away, everyone calms down, and everything goes back to normal. A nice, well-paid normal.
You're starting to not sound completely crazy.
I know, scary, isn't it? So bring them on. But first, food. I'm starving.
You have Corypholis. Corypholis. Oh my god, what?
Blood has soaked his face.
Thank you.
I wondered why all Skyhold seems suddenly brighter.
Shouldn't you be out there scouting?
In a bit. We're in Skyhold for supplies and a change of personnel. Not me, though. Indispensable.
So who's Scout Harding, really?
Me? Oh, I'm no one. Lived near Redcliffe all my life. Herded sheep for my neighbor. When the Inquisition came through my village, I helped by telling them everything I knew about the area. Then I signed on. Wanted to see the world before it was swallowed up by... that thing out there.
What's been going on?
Sister Liliana glanced at me today. I think she's gonna have me killed.
Jesus.
What's been going on?
Seeker Cassandra came through here, looking like a storm cloud. That's just her face, though, isn't it?
I have to go.
You learn fast, but then you need to.
Actually, don't I have a garden? Somewhere. I don't think this is it. Nope. That is definitely not it. Fuck it. I'll find it later. I got shit to do. Do shit. Fuck it. I want to do a story mission. How about that?
Adamant Fortress has stood against the Darkspawn since the time of the Second Blight.
Fortunately for us, that means it was built before the age of modern siege equipment. A good trebuchet will do major damage to those ancient walls. And thanks to our Lady Ambassador...
Lady Cyril of Jadar was pleased to lend the Inquisition her sappers. They've already delivered the trebuchets. That is the good news.
And the bad news?
Erimond called the ritual at the western approach a test. He may already be raising his army of demons in the fortress.
The Inquisition forces can breach the gate, but if the wardens already have their demons...
I found records of Adamant's construction. There are choke points we can use to limit the field of battle.
That's good. We may not be able to defeat them outright. But if we cut off reinforcements, we can carve you a path to Warden Commander Clarel.
Taking this fortress is going to get a lot of good soldiers killed.
Our soldiers know the risks, Inquisitor. And they know what they're fighting for.
It'll be hard fought, no way around it. But we'll get that gate open.
It's also possible that some wardens may be sympathetic to our cause. The warriors may be willing to listen to reason, though I doubt they will turn against Clarel directly. The mages, however, are slaves to Corypheus. They will fight to the death.
We've built the siege engines and readied our forces, Inquisitor. Give the word, and we march on Adamant.
Let's do it. I think I'm prepared. Maybe. God, I hope so. Like, how bad can it be, though, right?
pull back! They're through!
Well, I like when he set up.
Best make use of it. We'll keep the main host of demons occupied for as long as we can.
That's a worrying lack of specificity there, Commander.
There are more of them than I was hoping, Inquisitor.
You don't say.
Warden Stroud will guard your back. Hawk is with our soldiers on the battlements. She's assisting them until you arrive. There's too much resistance on the walls. Our men on the ladders can't get a foothold. If you can clear out the enemies on the battlements, we'll cover your advance.
Seems to be no one likes my commentary. That sucks. Give you the option. Constitution. Yeah, I want that. And a supply crate. Also want that. Okay, let's go. Yourself right now? You're a bitch. Like a tank over here being a badass.
Die!
Okay, we're on the battlements. Okay.
Press on ahead, your worship. We'll clear a path for the rest of our forces. Potions are too. Actually, if I haven't even took potions yet. Check. I'm gonna take a regen. Be on the safe side. I'm getting ready to fight a cloud, isn't it? Okay, Banshee's dead. Shit, Sherlock. Thank you.
fire the demons, not so much.
Gotta get that gold, man. Okay, let's get that out of here. Where are we at right now? It's a nice shield. Stop jumping and loot the fucking shit. Jesus. Oh my god. Stop it. Okay. I don't even need these surprise fucking crates. I'm just taking them just because. I'll take that just to sell it. Here we go.
Wardens! We are betrayed by the very world we have sworn to protect!
The Inquisition is inside, Clarel. We have no time to stand on ceremony.
These men and women are giving their lives, Magister. That might mean little in Tavinta, but for the Wardens, it is a sacred duty. It has been many long years, my friend.
Too many, Clarel. If my sword arm can no longer serve the Wardens, then my blood will have to do.
It will.
Stop them! We must complete the ritual!
I'm sure you can't wait for Clarel to do that. How else are you going to bind her?
Yes, Inquisitor. I want to bind the Warden Commander to a demon. Everyone in this room already knows that. And yes, the ritual requires blood sacrifice. Hate me for that if you must, but do not hate the Wardens for doing their duty.
We make the sacrifices no one else will. Our warriors die proudly for a world that will never thank them.
And then your Tavinter ally binds the mages to Corypheus!
Corypheus? But he's dead.
These people will say anything to shake your confidence, Clarel.
Bring it through!
Thank you.
Please. I've seen more than my share of blood magic. It is never worth the cost.
I trained half of you myself. Do not make me kill you to stop this madness.
Be ready with the ritual, Clarel. This demon is truly worthy of your strength.
The Grey Wardens have a proud history. You stopped the Blight at the Silent Plains, at Starkhaven, and Hunterfell, at Aisley, and Denerim. This world owes you a debt it can never repay. I would not stand against you if I did not know you were being misused.
Clarel, we have come so far. You're the only one who can do this.
Perhaps we could test the truth of these charges to avoid more bloodshed.
Or perhaps I should bring in a more reliable ally. My master thought you might come here, Inquisitor. He sent me this to welcome you.
destroyed the Grey Wardens.
You did that to yourself, you stupid bitch. All I did was dangle a little power before your eyes, and you couldn't wait to get your hands bloody. Serve a new god.
I will never serve the Blight.
Where are we?
We were falling.
If this is the afterlife, the Chantry owes me an apology. This looks nothing like the Maker's bosom.
No. The Inquisitor used the mark to open another rift. We fell through. I believe we're in the Fade.
Much different the last time I was here.
The first time I entered the Fade, it looked like a lovely castle filled with gold and silks. I met a marvelous desire demon, as I recall. We chatted and ate grapes before he attempted to possess me. Perhaps the difference is that we are here physically. This is no one's dream.
The stories say you walked out of the Fade at Haven. Was it like this?
I don't know. I still can't remember what happened the last time I did this.
Well, whatever happened at Haven, we can't assume we're safe now. That huge demon was right on the other side of that rift Aramund was using, and there could be others.
Shipples, fuck, shit, crap, Fade, shit, ass, demons, crap!
In our world, the rift the demons came through was nearby, in the main hall. Can we escape the same way?
Sounds like our best option. There, let's go.
Imagine it, to walk in the Fade and survive.
There's no guarantee. Thank you.
a look around, right?
By the Maker. Could that be?
I greet you, Warden. And you, Champion.
Divine Justinia. Most holy.
Cassandra.
Cassandra, you knew the Divine. Is this really her?
I don't know. It is said the souls of the dead pass through the Fade and sometimes linger, but we know the spirits lie. Be wary, Inquisitor.
I fear the Divine is indeed dead. It is likely we face a spirit, or a demon.
You think my survival impossible, yet here you stand alive in the Fade yourselves. In truth, proving my existence either way would require time we do not have.
Really? How hard is it to answer one question? I'm a human, and you are?
I am here to help you. You do not remember what happened at the Temple of Sacred Ashes, Inquisitor.
No, I don't.
The memories you have lost were taken by the demon that serves Corypheus. It is the nightmare you forget upon waking. It feeds off memories of fear and darkness, growing fat upon the terror. The false calling that terrified the Wardens into making such grave mistakes? It's work.
I would gladly avenge the insult this nightmare dealt my brethren.
You will have your chance, brave Warden. This place of darkness is its lair.
Corypheus seems to have a lot of demons at his disposal. How does he command so many?
I know not how he commands his army of demons. His power may come from the Blight itself, but the Nightmare serves willingly. For Corypheus has brought much terror to this world. He was one of the Magisters who unleashed the first Blight upon the world, was he not? Every child's cry as the Archdemon circles. Every dwarf's whimper in the deep roads. The nightmare has fed well.
How do we hurt it?
That's a little optimistic, isn't it?
You hurt it by escaping the Fade and leading your people against Corypheus.
That wasn't what I meant.
I know. But for now, it is the best answer I can give you. When you entered the Fade at Heaven, the demon took a part of you. Before you do anything else, you must recover it. These are your memories, Inquisitor.
So, your Marg did not come from Andraste. It came from the orb Corypheus used in his ritual.
Corypheus intended to rip open the veil, use the anchor to enter the Fade, and throw open the doors of the Black City. Not for the old gods, but for himself. When you disrupted his plan, the orb bestowed the anchor upon you instead.
Was that everything you wanted me to see?
For the time being. You cannot escape the lair of the nightmare until you regain all that it took from you. You have recovered some of yourself, but now it knows you are here. You must make haste. I will prepare the way ahead.
Something troubles you, Hawk.
I wondered if you might be concerned about the Grey Wardens holding the Divine in that vision. Their actions led to her death.
I assumed he had taken their minds, as you have seen him do before. Come, we can argue after we escape this dark place.
Oh, I intend to.
Could that truly have been the Most Holy?
Well, I have no idea if it's a spirit who's not acting like one. No demon would have been so helpful without asking something in return.
So she's not real? Then the nightmare's fake too, right? Right?
A demon that steals fears from the minds of men. After what it did to my fellow wardens, I pray we find some way to strike it down.
Have a visitor. Some foolish little boy comes to steal the fear
I kindly lifted from his shoulders. You should have thanked me and left your fear where it lay, forgotten. You think the pain will make you stronger? What fool filled your mind with such drivel? The only one who grows stronger from your fears is me. But you are a guest here in my home. So by all means, let me return what you have forgotten.
That's it, right? Not so bad. You're not so bad! Surely these are but the Nightmare's minions. I hate this place. What are those things?
Perhaps I should be afraid, facing the most powerful members of the Inquisition. Sarah, 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 if you shoot an arrow at me, I'll know where you are. I mistook you for your father.
Rather uncalled for.
Your Inquisitor is a fraud, Cassandra. Yet more evidence there is no Maker, that all your faith has been for naught.
Die in the void, demon.
Did you think you mattered, Hawk? Did you think anything you ever did mattered? You couldn't even save your city. How could you expect to strike down a god?
Smaller fears, I would wager. Scavenging whatever the Nightmare leaves behind.
And, of course, they look like giant spiders. Didn't see no spiders. I'd have taken bloody spiders.
souls. The demons look different to each of us. Hurt them.
The nightmare is closer now. It knows you seek escape. With each moment, it grows stronger. There is not much time, Inquisitor.
We should keep moving. Keep running!
Go!
I thought it was Andraste sending me from the Fade. It was the Divine behind me. And then you... she died.
Yes.
So this creature is simply a spirit?
You don't say.
I am sorry if I disappoint you.
Nightmare watched Corypheus and grew powerful off the fear. Were you like that for the Divine? A spirit watching her from the Fade, inspired by her faith.
If that is the story you wish to tell, it is not a bad one.
What we do know is that the mortal Divine perished at the temple, thanks to the Grey Wardens.
As I said, the Grey Wardens responsible for that crime were under the control of Corypheus. We can discuss this further once we return to Adamant.
Assuming that the Wardens and their demon army didn't destroy the Inquisition while we were gone.
How dare you judge us? You killed almost every mage in Kirkwall.
Yes, because too many of them were practicing blood magic, just like your Wardens. But you'd ignore that, because you can't imagine a world without the Wardens, even if that's what we need.
The Wardens are a risk. Send them away before they cause even more trouble.
It isn't like you can just get rid of them. I mean, it's never good when they show, but they're supposed to be heroes.
They might still be useful. What if Corypheus conjures another blight? You never know.
Sweet Maker, could both of you please shut up? We can argue once we've escaped from the giant fear demon.
Inquisitor.
The nightmare has found us.
Form up.
I'm with you.
Whatever she is our way out of here.
Wardens, how must it feel to devote your whole life to the Wardens, only to watch them fall? Or worse, to know that you were responsible for their destruction? When the next blight comes, will they curse your name?
With the Maker's blessing, we will end this wretched beast.
Do you think you can fight me? I am your every fear come to life. I am the veiled hand of Corypheus himself. The demon army you fear, I command it. They are bound all through me.
Ah, so if we banish you, we banish the demons. Thank you, every fear come to life.
hard to trust my footing in this place.
Get through the rift, Inquisitor. Get through, and then slam it closed with all your strength. That will banish the army of demons and exile this cursed creature to the farthest reaches of the Fade. Liliana, I am sorry. I failed you too.
Nothing. You will die in agony.
cannot stand against me. Grow fat on your fear.
Warden's caused this. A warden must...
A warden must help them rebuild. That's your job. Corypheus is mine.
Hawk.
Say goodbye to Garrick for me.
The nightmare banished, Corypheus lost both his warden mages and his demon army. But in the stories your soldiers will tell, their inquisitor broke the spell with the Maker's blessing.
They came out of this alive. As far as I'm concerned, they can tell whatever stories they like.
And I suspect this will not be the last story they tell about you.
Inquisitor. The archdemon flew off as soon as you disappeared. The Venatori Magister is unconscious but alive. Cullen thought you might wish to deal with him yourself. As for the Wardens, those who weren't corrupted helped us fight the demons.
We stand ready to help make up for Clarel's tragic mistake.
Where is the champion? Hawk is not with us.
Hawk
sacrificed her life to save us and strike a decisive blow against Corypheus.
The champion is gone.
She gave her life not because she'd sworn an oath or been marked as special, but because someone had to do it.
Stroud, you're the senior surviving Grey Warden. What do we do now?
You stay and do whatever you can to help. Stroud believes that the Wardens are worth saving. And I trust him. You're still vulnerable to Corypheus, and possibly his Venatori. But there are plenty of demons that need killing.
After all that, you give them yet another chance?
While they do that, I'll report to the Wardens at Weishaupt. We won't be caught off guard by Corypheus again.
Thank you, Your Worship. We will not fail you.
Maker, watch over your Inquisition. It has been an honor.
Stroud sent me one final report. He's on his way to Weishaupt. As for the Grey Wardens, they are fighting demons and Red Templars while staying clear of Venatori. You dealt Corypheus a significant blow, Inquisitor.
The Grey Wardens carry respect in other nations. If we spread the word that the Inquisition has their support...
We may gain standing with nations that have suffered under the Blight. I will take the matter to Josephine. You took an army from Corypheus, but that will matter little if Orlais falls into chaos. All arrangements have been made for the ball in Helam Sheral. Let us know when you are ready to proceed.
I'll go as soon as I am able.
Good. Cullen, Josephine, and I will discuss the best way to gain an audience with the Empress. Speak with us when you are ready. What was she like?
Divine Justinia, or her soul, or the spirit that took her form. I read your report. I know it isn't clear, but...
You seemed calm, serene even, and she guided us the whole way through.
That does sound like her.
She did ask me to tell you something, though. She said, I'm sorry, I failed you too.
Oh. I should finish this before it slips my mind. Perhaps later we might discuss the matter further. Thank you.
told you gave the Grey Wardens another chance, Inquisitor. Would I have done the same, I wonder? Forgiveness can be difficult. I hope the Order values what you've done, and gives you no reason to regret it.
I trust everything is well with the mages?
A few malcontents claim you've put us in a new circle, but most are relieved to be safe.
I'll leave you to it.
I'm told you have Alexius researching magic for you. Research is always what made him happiest. Perhaps I'll even go talk to him eventually. One word of advice. If he suggests altering time as a way to solve all your problems, give it a pass.
I should go.
Naturally.
I cannot believe the Grey Wardens could even conceive of such a plan. To seek out these old gods deliberately, in some bizarre attempt to preempt the Blight.
Grey Wardens have always been dangerous. They care for nothing beyond stopping the Darkspawn.
Like a fair maiden chasing a butterfly off a cliff. Except that if you hadn't stopped them, we'd all have fallen.
Both fools and duty. Responsibility is not expertise. Action is not inherently superior to inaction. Forgive me. The entire idea is unnerving.
Yes?
Are you ever concerned that you've turned your back on your people?
I have done no such thing. I simply see no way to help the Elves, oppressed as they are now.
You could teach them what you've learned. You could give them the tools to help themselves.
How many would listen? Most of the poor and oppressed do not want to work to improve their condition. They want only comfort, an affirmation that they are good for being poor and oppressed. I might reach a few at most, but you are right. That is more than I reach doing nothing. I suppose I'm just tired of fighting.
What do you mean you're tired of fighting? Fighting what?
Did you think I honed my magical skills to impress spirits? I have joined my share of causes, but when I offered lessons learned in the Fade, I was derided by my enemies, and sometimes by my allies. Liar, fool, madman. There are endless ways to say someone isn't worth listening to. Over time, it grinds away at you.
If you're tired of losing, you might consider winning.
You're right. I've given that advice to others in the past. Apparently, I needed to hear it myself. Perhaps there is hope for you yet, Inquisitor. To what do I owe the pleasure?
We'll talk later.
Of course.
Now this is a hall worthy of the Inquisition.
Adamant's influence continues, Your Worship. I submit Lord Livius Erimond of Virantium, who remains loyal to Corypheus. We found him alive, offering extreme resistance, likely because the Order will ask for his head. In more colorful terms. To say nothing of justice you might personally require for what was suffered in the Fade.
Many places felt the pain of adamant. You will answer for a great deal.
I recognize none of this proceeding. You have no authority to judge me.
On the contrary, many officials have communicated that they will defer to the Inquisitor on this matter.
Because they fear not just Corypheus, but Taventa. Rightful ruler of every piece of ground you trod in your pathetic life. I serve the living God. Bring down your blades and free me from the physical. Glory awaits me.
Since death is a validation for you, I will delay it. Lord Livius Aramond of Virantium, you'll spend the rest of your days in the deepest, darkest hole we can find.
We shall see which of us outlives our legacy, Inquisitor.
Another of the lingering pains of Adamant, your worship. Sir Ruth is a senior warden of the Order. She was one of the many who slit the throat of another to bind a demon. She does not contest this. In fact, she surrendered to us. She requests no mercy. She wants the public justice of the Headman's axe.
You're very serious about this. Is more death the answer?
There is no excuse for my actions. I murdered another of the Order. That blood marks me more than the Blight ever could.
Accepting their actions while thralls of Corypheus, many treaties allow wardens any extreme if it opposes the Blight.
I can't do it. I can't use the greater good to justify my crimes, as if it would create a future I could be a part of. It is wrong that this broke me. I've done worse with full sanction. I can do nothing except be an example of the cost.
The Inquisition stands for faith. Our work has greater purpose. Sometimes we need a reminder. Sir Ruth, the Herald of Andraste forgives you in her name. Find peace in that.
Your worship, I will try.
To work?
nice, simple plan.
Did I ever tell you about the time Hawk was on a Merchant Guild hit list? Hawk's uncle got into an investment scheme with a couple of merchant caste businessmen. They took a lot of people's coin in order to arrange the import of wandering hills from the Anderfels. A delicacy, I'm told. Their weird foreign foodstuffs arrived alive, and one of them, true to its name, wandered off in the middle of the night.
Keep going. I'd like to hear the rest of the story.
The guild traced the shipments to Hawk's uncle, but as usual, he was so far in debt he couldn't see daylight. So they went after Hawk instead. They sent guys from the local carter to Hawk's estate one night. 5 big dusters, armed to the teeth. They kick in the door, and Hawk yells, "You're just in time," and drags them over to a game of Wicked Grace. They played 2 hands of cards before the city guard showed up to take them away. A couple of them became regulars in our weekly game. Hawk just had that effect on people. I always wanted to tell that one. Thanks. I guess I've got some letters to write. Isabella should know. Excuse me.
Put that stuff aside. Take a break.
Best advice I've ever heard. I've been meaning to come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
I'm a person like any other. You don't have to treat me differently.
Oh, maybe you're right. Maybe I'm overthinking things. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
So what exactly am I to the people out there?
The sky tears open, demons everywhere. To ordinary folks, these are the end times. The only hope they have is you. You're the sign that somebody might hear their prayers. That maybe they're not abandoned after all. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Whatever I am to Thedas, I'm still just an ordinary person.
So, just a regular person, like anybody else. Right. I should probably get back to work, unless, you up for a game of Wicked Grace?
Stefan finally died. It was a blessing, really.
Writing does not come naturally to me, as I'm certain you can imagine.
Let me guess, you're composing a love poem.
I couldn't. Not even if my life depended on it.
It's not that hard.
Yes, it is. Poetry takes finesse. It takes grace.
Do you think you don't have those things?
Historians will one day ask what happened at Adamant Fortress, in the Fade. I was there. I saw it with my own eyes. It must be recorded.
That's an excellent idea, Cassandra.
I certainly thought so, until I started writing. I still don't know what to say about the spirit of the divine. I saw her there, heard her voice, yet I cannot claim with certainty it was really her. The Chantry teaches us that the souls of the dead pass through the Fade, so it could have been her, yet even so,
Do you really think it might have been her? A ghost?
A ghost. A remnant of her hopes and memories. Her lingering will to do good. Those things are all possible. Nobody knows for certain what happens after we die. A spirit could have assumed her form, but why? It helped you, as Justinia herself would have.
Perhaps it doesn't matter what she really was then.
It matters to me, to what I must write. I must interpret what I saw, yet I am no priest, no philosopher. I am a warrior.
I think it was a spirit, that's all.
Perhaps it saw Justinia's soul, and admired it enough to carry on her wishes. I hope that's true. I want to believe it. When I realized we were physically in the Fade, I was terrified, almost beyond reason. The last time such a thing happened, we created Darkspawn. We created Corypheus. The world needs to know the truth this time. No more legends lost to the ages. Be careful, Inquisitor. Dragon blood can change you in ways you will not expect.
How do you know that?
Dragon hunters were once revered in Nevarra, and the Pentagasts were the most famous. Many of my family became reavers, harnessing the power of dragon's blood against their quarry. But each one went terribly insane in the end. Eventually, it was forbidden.
They all went mad?
It was their own doing, I understand. Greed drove them to use more and more. The blood deformed them, caused growth, scales, things of that nature. They became enraged by little things. In time, that rage swallowed them. They committed murders, killed entire families, unspeakable things. Tales from hundreds of years ago, of course, likely exaggerated, but perhaps not entirely.
I don't like the sound of that.
If anyone is a match for dragon's blood, it is you. I only suggest caution.
Do you have any advice for me?
Now that the Grey Warden threat is dealt with, we must investigate the assassination plot. One can only hope it's not too late. More chaos in Olay only helps Corypheus.
Okay, well, that's gonna wrap this video up, or stream, I should say. No video yet, my stream. Okay, so, I'm gonna upload part, I think 6 is what I'm on right now, to YouTube. Dryhelix is the channel. If you like it, comment, like, and subscribe. Y'all stay awesome, and I'll see you later.